Good evening, everyone. I'm Carol Goldsmith.
And I'm Michael Cogdell. A rollover wreck today killed a father and injured his passenger.
The Anderson County Sheriff says they were trying to speed away from a deputy when the crash happened. News 4's Mike McCormick is live and local at the sheriff's office for us tonight. Mike, you spoke to that driver's mother?
Yeah, that's right, Carol and Michael. And she says her son accidentally dropped a $20 bill out the window. He turned around, stopped, got out, and tried to look for it. And when he saw a deputy come up, he got back in the car and drove away.
The strength of a wrecker gave us our first good look at the car involved in a wreck that killed a man and left his family in tears.
These are his little daughters. They will have to live the rest of their life without their daddy.
The Anderson County Sheriff says a deputy tried to stop the black Mustang around 1 p.m. because investigators had been looking for one that may have been stolen. The sheriff says the car took off and the deputy chased it.
The speed got up to about 60 or so miles an hour, so the officer actually backed off before going into the curve.
The sheriff tells us the deputy eventually made it around the curve on Middleton Road and found this. The car rolled and even took out several trees. The coroner tells us 27-year-old Corey Madden was the driver. He was ejected and found in his underwear. The coroner says he believes Madden was trying to take off his clothes while speeding away to keep from being identified if he got away.
And that's who killed my youngin', and you'll never make me think any different. The police killed my youngin' by chasing him.
The sheriff says the highway patrol is in charge of the investigation and will review the deputy's dash cam video to make sure he followed procedure.
Corey was just a very misunderstood person. He did a lot of things wrong. He was on drugs. And we begged him and begged him to get off the drug. I didn't want him on the drug. But he didn't deserve to die by a bunch of county cops chasing him.
Madden was married to Micah Madden.
He didn't deserve what happened to him.
He had three daughters.
Corey was a good man. He loved these girls, and he loved me, and he loved his baby mama.
And Tasha Foster, the passenger in that vehicle, was also ejected, according to troopers. She is being treated in the hospital tonight. We're told she was a friend of Corey Madden. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4, live tonight in Anderson County.